Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Bonsoir, mesdames et messieurs, ici, here, live at the Victoria Hall in Geneva, or online via the live stream on Medici.tv, Amadeus TV, or on YouTube. We are gathered for the finals of the international competition for young pianists in memory of Vladimir Horowitz, or to put it shortly, the Horowitz Competition, KYIV-GENEVA 2023. Welcome, bienvenue, laskavo prosim. My name is Christian Kuivenhove. I'm a concert pianist and presenter, and it is my sincere honor to be part of this extraordinary event tonight. An event in which we celebrate. We celebrate the talent of our three finalists, Kyoungsun Park, Julian Trevelyan, and Roman Fediurko. We celebrate their craftsmanship, their artistic abilities, their unique talent, and also the indestructible power of music that unites and brings people together from all over the world in harmony, and to which their promising future careers will contribute. As I am sure you are all aware of, this event has been organized under the most extreme circumstances. Since 1995, the Horowitz Competition has been organized in Kyiv, and for its 13th edition, it had to find refuge. That refuge was that refuge was given to them by the city of Geneva and by the generous efforts of the World Federation of International Music Competitions. And it is also because of the belief and the determination of one woman that we are here tonight, Irina Pozdziankina.
Mesdames et Messieurs les représentants des autorités cantonales et municipales de la ville de Genève, Monsieur le Président de la Fédération Mondiale des Concours Internationaux de Musique, Madame la Présidente du Concours Horowitz de Kiev, Monsieur le Secrétaire Général de la Fédération Mondiale des Concours Internationaux de Musique, Monsieur le Président du Jury et Chef d'Orchestre de la soirée, Mesdames et Messieurs les pianistes, Mesdames et Messieurs, au nom des autorités de la ville de Genève, j'ai le plaisir et l'honneur d'être présente ce soir parmi vous à l'occasion de l'ouverture de la finale du concours international Vladimir Horowitz au Victoria Hall, ce lieu dédié à la musique classique, vous le savez, et dont la magnificence se double de qualité acoustique exceptionnelle. Alors après plus d'un an de conflit, la situation qui prévaut aujourd'hui en Ukraine est toujours dramatique, une situation qui nous attriste, qui nous bouleverse. Et dans ce contexte difficile, eh bien, je me réjouis que l'édition 2023 de cette prestigieuse compétition qui honore la mémoire de l'éminent artiste ukrainien et légendaire pianiste Vladimir Horowitz ait pu trouver refuge dans notre cité. Pour Genève, ce concours est le signe d'abord de la solidarité entre les villes. Genève, ville de paix, forte de sa tradition d'accueil, de ses valeurs humanistes, Genève, ville dépositaire des conventions qui portent son nom et qui constituent les piliers du droit international humanitaire, Genève n'a pas hésité un seul instant lorsque les autorités de la ville de Kiev et les représentants de la Fédération mondiale des concours internationaux de musique l'ont approché pour que ce concours puisse se tenir ici chez nous. Et depuis un peu plus d'une semaine, des partitions jouées par tous ces jeunes pianistes provenant de différents pays ont résonné comme un véritable appel à la paix, quoi de plus harmonieux qu'un souffle de grande musique pour vivre ensemble un moment de sérénité qui nous élève et qui nous rassemble. Je suis convaincue que la musique, langage universel par excellence, est capable de transcender les frontières et d'amener un peu d'espoir. Et je formule le vœu que depuis Genève, ces notes de musique classique pourront apaiser la situation, faire taire le bruit des canons et que l'édition 2024 du concours pourra à nouveau se tenir en Ukraine. Je tiens à remercier vivement la Fédération mondiale des concours internationaux de musique pour son engagement. Je félicite tous les jeunes pianistes qui ont participé à ce concours. Aujourd'hui, mesdames et messieurs, la ville de Genève se réjouit que nous puissions ensemble partager ce moment, rendre ainsi hommage à Vladimir Horowitz, cet immense pianiste parmi les plus célèbres du XXe siècle, et contribuer ainsi à préserver un héritage culturel qui permet aux jeunes générations que nous aurons le plaisir d'écouter ce soir de bâtir leur avenir. Je vous remercie de votre attention et surtout je vous souhaite un magnifique concert.
It is time for music now and for our first finalist, Julian Trevelyan. He was educated at the École Normale Musique in Paris, and at Oxford University. He was prize winner already at the 𝗞𝘆𝗶𝘃𝗦 competition in Zurich and the Montreux in Paris. And for the finals, he has chosen the 23rd piano concerto by Mozart. It was written in 1756, and it is one of the highlights of the classical concertos. It was recorded by Vladimir Horowitz as well, late in his life, in 1987. But tonight, you will enjoy Julian's interpretation of this beautiful piece, especially for the second movement. I hope you have some tissues at hand. We'll give the orchestra some time to tune, and then please welcome KYIV-GENEVA, conductor of tonight, Julian Trevelyan, and of course, your guest of the Liszt and the National Symphony Orchestra of Ukraine, Mozart.
Thank you.
Julian Trevelyan in Mozart's 23rd piano concerto with the Orchestra de la Suisse Romande and the musicians from the National Symphony Orchestra of Ukraine. I am sure that Julian's dog is very proud because he brought his dog, sweet, small, white dog, was back just backstage. I could tell. Very proud of him. Wonderful. Now, we will have an intermission now because we need a bit more orchestra for the second half. Triangle player, for instance, for Liszt's first piano concerto that will be played by Kyoungsun Park. And before that, we will hear the Shuman concerto in A minor by Fediurko. So we'll have a small break and then I will welcome you back here at Victoria Hall for the people in the live stream. Stick around, get some coffee, tea, or something strong, and we'll be back in about 25 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, mesdames et messieurs. I'll wait a little till everybody has found their seats and to welcome you back at the second half of the finals of the Horowitz Competition, KYIV-GENEVA 2023. Two more pianists to go, two more piano concertos to go, Schumann and Liszt, before we know the end results. But did you know that the organization of the Horowitz competition does much more than organizing a competition? They, for instance, have a summer academy, which I can tell you from my own experience can be as important in the life of a musician as participating in a competition. As a matter of fact, Maxime, our concertmeister, he can confirm it because we just discovered that we studied there in the same year, about 2002, right? Something like that, yes, yes. Horowitz said about the profession of being a pianist, without intellect, you will be a fiasco, without technique, an amateur, and without a heart, a machine. Now, the first two were taken care of thoroughly at that academy, the technique and the intellect, but also the third, the heart, my heart, was touched during my studies there. It was during an evening when we walked from the outdoor concert hall to the metro, and the metros in Kyiv are very deep, you must know, the stairs are very long. And approaching them, I had seen a boy selling flowers with his mother. Given his dirty feet and his old clothes, they were obviously poor, but as a teenager, I didn't have to spend much either. When we were walking down, however, I heard something fall, and it seemed to be a flip-flop, a slipper. And I looked up, and at the top of the stairs, I saw the boy. So I picked up the flip-flop, gave it back to him, sprinted down again to catch up with my friends. But just a moment later, I heard fast footsteps, and I was tapped on the shoulder, and there he was, the boy, with in his hands flowers. I reached for money now, but before my hand could reach my pocket, he was gone again. He had disappeared into the night, leaving me with the most beautiful present I have ever had. A bouquet of flowers, but also a lesson in life, a lesson of kindness, of modesty, and of dignity. And when I think back on him, which I have done a lot lately, 20 years later, I imagine where he would be right now. Is he fighting? Is he flying? Is he hiding in those very deep metros? But more than that, I like to think and I like to wish that one day, very soon, this boy will fill the streets of Kyiv again with flowers. We are going to listen to the second pianist of tonight, the second finalist of the Horowitz Competition, KYIV-GENEVA 2022. He was born in Kyiv. He chose Schumann's Piano Concerto in A minor as his final piece, and he will be performing it with the Orchestre de la Suisse Romande, the National Symphony Orchestra of Ukraine, and Kirill Karabits as conductor. Please, after the orchestra has tuned, welcome Roman Fediurko.
Thank you.
Roman Fediurko and Schumann's piano concerto in A minor. We are getting ready for the third finalist and the last of tonight and of the Horowitz Competition KYIV-GENEVA 2023, Kyoungsun Park. He was educated at the Universität der Künste in Berlin, at the Hochschule für Musik in München, and also at the Royal College of Music in London. Won several prizes already, award winner at the Singapore International Piano Competition in 2020, the Windsor International Piano Competition, and also the Isang Jung International Music Competition. Kyoungsun has chosen Liszt's first concerto in E flat major. It took Liszt more than 25 years to come to a final version of this piece. Sketches had already been in his sketchbook in 1830. In 1849, he published a first version, but it took him another 6 years to premiere it in Weimar, together with Hector Berlioz conducting. It is a special piece in the piano concerto literature because it's one of the first concertos in which all the movements follow each other attacca, so without any pauses in between. It is notorious for its opening chords at the piano, the octaves, jumping octaves, but not only that, it's also notorious for the triangle player. Toi toi. Toi toi. We will give you some time to polish your triangle. We'll give you some time to tune, and then please welcome Kyoungsun Park with Liszt's first concerto.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Kyoungsun Park, the third and last performance of tonight, and therewith the last performance of the Horowitz Competition KYIV-GENEVA 2023. Before I will tell you how we will go on with this evening, how the award ceremony will look like, let's give them one more, your warmest applause, the orchestra. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for being here. Orchestre de la Suisse Romande, National Symphony Orchestra of Ukraine. Thank you very much for being with us and for your wonderful playing and support of the three pianists. Now, of course, it is time for the jury to deliberate, and I would like to invite the jury to leave the hall first, to leave the hall now, to do your job now. Bravo for the jury. Encourage them. And we expect them to need around 30 minutes to decide who will be third, second, and first. Because after that, we will be back with the award ceremony. During that, a number of special prizes will be handed out, and of course, number 3, 2, and 1. But there's another prize, your prize. You have a vote as well tonight. For the people watching on the live stream, unfortunately, it's only possible for those here present in Geneva at the Victoria Hall to vote. It is done in a very simple way. You have a program book. In it, you will find a QR code. We all now know how a QR code works, I guess. You scan it with your smartphone. It takes you to a website on which you fill in your seat and then your choice. If, however, you have difficulties, or if you don't have a smartphone, or it doesn't work, then in the foyers you will find our staff, and they will be able to help you. They have devices, so if it doesn't work for you, go to them. Now, we will have a break, and after that we will be back with the award ceremony. Thank you very much, see you in a bit. Thank you again. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen, the big moment, the award ceremony of the Horowitz Competition KYIV-GENEVA 2023. The jury has deliberated, they made their decision, but before we go there and before we go to the handing out of the prizes, there's one person I have to put into the spotlight. When you look behind me, you see, you cannot all see it, but the lid over the keys of this beautiful Steinway grand piano is closed. All the notes have been played, sometimes perhaps a few more notes than written, perhaps some were lost during performances, but that's part of the job. And all notes have been played, this decision has been made. But as a pianist, and we share that only with the triangle player, we are the only instrumentalists that do not take their own instrument wherever we go or wherever we play. A violinist has a violin, a cellist has a cellist. It can go anywhere, but a piano cannot. And therefore, we rely on the instrument that is there, but perhaps even more importantly, we rely on the technician that works the piano. The concert technician that prepares the piano, it not only tunes it, but also makes sure that everything works in the proper way and that it is as smooth as possible, so we do not have any hindrance in performing whatever we like, however we like. And for this competition, there was one man responsible for the piano, and I would like to ask your big applause for him, because he did a wonderful job and he worked very, very hard. When we have breakfast, he has already been working for 2 hours. He's up there at the balcony, François Jérôme Vincent. As I understood, he's the best Steinway technician, so if you need your piano tuned at home, call him. But I'm afraid you can't afford him. Thank you, François. Thank you very much. Okay, let's go to the speeches first. Of course, there are several people that want to say something, and we will start with the president of the World Federation of International Music Competitions, the organization that, as I said, has provided refuge for the Horowitz competition here. And the president of that federation is Peter Paul Keinrath.
Bonsoir, chère Madame la Maire. Dobry wieczór, дорогая голова комиссии Киевской Мисской Ради Спитан культуры Виктория Муха. Дорогие друзья из Украины, good evening, dear guests and audience in this beautiful Victoria Hall and around the globe following us over the live stream. Le 13e concours international de piano Vladimir Horowitz touche à son fin. Nous avons passé des journées merveilleuses et très intenses dans cette belle ville de Genève, international et hospitalière. Of course, this was no ordinary music competition. From the beginning of the terrible war against Ukraine, we, the board of the World Federation of International Music Competitions and its members, took a clear stance. Full solidarity with the victims of this unjustifiable attack. Total boycott of any propaganda and exploitation of the arts in the name of nationalism. To stay true to our values, but to not ever abandon the willingness to enter into dialogue, however complicated it may turn out to be. This is easier said than done, as we all know. But one thing is certain. All of us have learned a lot over the last couple of days. Nothing can be taken for granted. Once again, we recognize that we live in disruptive times. We just dealt with the global pandemic that threatened to reduce international musical life to isolated provincial fragments, only to enter a world in which war is once again preeminent. The World Federation of International Music Competitions is not only an umbrella organization for the world's outstanding music competitions. Already, my Genevian predecessor Didier Schnork turned it into a dynamic, proactive institution which is committed to be a compass with its leadership. The fact that we hold the Horowitz Piano Competition at our headquarters in Geneva is to be understood in precisely this sense. A prestigious foundation based in this city and many other partners made this project possible. Additionally, I would like to express my deep gratitude to the following people. Our absolutely extraordinary Secretary General Florian Riem, together with our WFIMC staff. Empowered by some very experienced people from the Concours de Genève. Irina Postyalskina, with her wonderful team from Kyiv. And the jury under the guidance of the conductor and chair, Kirill Karabits. This Horowitz Piano Competition gives us real and strong hope that the future in the name of culture and human dignity will be bright. Thank you for your attention. Dakuyusa uvagu. Merci pour votre attention.
Thank you very much for your beautiful words, Peter Paul Kindrat. The next to give the floor to is a special woman. She's the president of the International Charitable Fund of Vladimir Horowitz Competition. In other words, she's the boss. Irina Postyalskina.
Dear friends, today the Horowitz competition is not at its home in Kyiv, but we are here on a mission of utmost importance, the survival of our culture, and our spirit depends on it. The whole world is helping us in this task. The World Federation of International Music Competitions is supporting and assisting the Horowitz competition to hold this 2023 edition in Geneva. I'm very grateful to our colleagues from the Federation for this idea and for their hard, dedicated work. I'm also grateful to all our partners for supporting this special, very special project. The winners of this competition will get very important opportunities for a young artist, concerts around the world. However, they can always say that here in Geneva, they began their journey to the Olympic of their artistry. And of course, we await for performance in a peaceful and beautiful Kyiv as soon as possible. Thank you very much.
Next is a man who has been on the podium tonight a few times already in a very important role as conductor, but he was also the chairman of the jury in, during this competition, and that is Kirill Karabits.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I think I've already said a lot this evening, but I just want to say how privileged I feel to have spent 10 days in this fantastic city and with these wonderful people and all the jury members. The best. They're really the best. We didn't always agree on all the decisions, but I felt very strongly that we were a team, and all the decisions are thought, and you know, and nothing happened by accident. It happened to me that as a young musician, I was associated to Horowitz Competition when it was founded many years ago, and I see what a fantastic project it became now, and the impact of the project. One could feel it, you know, the pianists who went through this competition, they're everywhere. They're in Europe, they're winning other competitions. They really became part of the piano world. So I think the role of this competition is absolutely difficult to describe. And especially in this very special edition, I feel deeply grateful from me as a Ukrainian musician, and I'm sure all Ukrainians around the world would agree with me that the best way to support the country is to support its culture and to support its cultural identity. And this is what this competition is about. This competition actually revealed the fact that Vladimir Horowitz was born in Kyiv, which the world didn't know about. So now he became part of our tradition and our culture. And I'm really deeply grateful to Switzerland, and especially to the city of Geneva, for hosting this competition, because this is the best possible investment and help you can do to a country, because we understand very well that the country that has its strong cultural identity will simply exist and be in the future and will be undefeatable. Thank you very much, and it was really great pleasure to be part of this project.
And the last to have the center of the stage is a man who deserves it very much, Secretary General of the WFIMC, the World Federation of International Music Competitions, Florian Riem.
Madame la maire Marie-Barbie Chapuis, Madame la conseillère Victoria Moucha, Mesdames et Messieurs, chers amis, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, today marks the end of a great project, the Horowitz Competition KYIV-GENEVA. A competition that could not be held in its hometown because of a war that has destroyed the lives, hopes, and dreams of innumerable people. A competition meant as a gesture of support and solidarity with our friends and colleagues in Kyiv and with young artists in all parts of the world. Over the past half year, it has been a wonderful experience to see this project grow and to see how several arts organizations have come together, have worked together hand in hand. The Horowitz Competition from Kyiv and its president, Irina Polstyankina. The World Federation of Music Competitions and its president, Peter Paul Kainrat. The Concours de Genève, its president, Matteo Inaudi, and Secretary General, Didier Schnock. Les Amis du Concours de Genève. The Orchestre de la Suisse Romande, its president, Charlotte de Sénart-Clos, and director, Steve Roger. The Symphony Orchestra of Ukraine, and its director, Alexander Hornostai. To all these people, I give our heartfelt thanks. Without you, this could not have happened. But it also has been remarkable to see that in a short time, several Swiss and Ukrainian foundations, companies, international media, the Canton of Geneva, and the City of Geneva have come together to support us. I would just like to mention a few, among them the Art Mentor Foundation Luzern, the Vere Music Fund, the Loterie Romande, but also Steinway and Sons, R2 Livestream, and Unique Piece Design in Seoul, South Korea. But it has been truly amazing to see how almost 30 host families from this city, together with you, our audience, have embraced this competition and all of its artists, and have brought it to the success we have seen during the past week that we have seen tonight. We would like to thank all of you for your great efforts to make the Horowitz competition KYIV-GENEVA happen. We hope that the performances, the experiences, the exposure, and the newfound friendships and connections will enrich and secure the future of this outstanding arts institution. And we look forward to see the competition happen again at home in Kyiv in the very near future. Thank you all.
Thank you, Florian. Now it's time for the award ceremony and the handing out of the prizes. And those prizes, of course, were decided for by the jury. They have made their selection during the whole week, and it resulted into three finalists, and it will result now into three major prizes, but also in numerous special prizes. I want to stress, however, that selecting was not the only job the jury had. Supporting is, I guess, also a very important part of being part of a jury, because giving your ear to someone for 25 minutes and listen, be attentive, and give them a chance to prove themselves in front of you is a way of support. And also the jury had many feedback sessions with all the participants, so in that way, I guess we hope that nobody leaves empty-handed. It's an experience, you learn something, and hopefully you don't feel, as a participant who didn't make it to the final, that you lost something. Anyways, there will be winning of something, and the jury has decided. Let me introduce those people, those wonderful people, to you. They were chaired by Kirill Karabits. He will stay there, but because he has some other things to do, some other duties, but please call forward Michel Berov, Rico Gulda, Maria Muravska, Pierce Lane, Sisiye, Tisa Ho, Alexei Gorlach, and Giuseppe Albanese. And also, I want to invite on the stage our stars of tonight, the three finalists, Julian Trevelyan, Roman Fediurko, and Kyoungsun Park. And where are they? Where are you? Yeah. Otherwise, we'll take it home, right? Julian Trevelyan, Roman Fediurko, Kyoungsun Park. You guys, this is the moment it's all about. This is the moment it's all about. All right, it's time for the prizes. Before we go to third, second, and first, there are several special prizes to be handed out, and I will be assisted in that. We will start with the World Federation of International Music Competitions prize. It is for the best interpretation of a work by a Ukrainian composer. It will be handed out by Peter Paul Kainrat. Please come, Peter Paul, because I will tell you who will get it. And this prize, the WFIMC prize, goes to Roman Fediurko. The second special prize is the Horowitz Prize for the best interpretation of a virtuoso Horowitz transcription. It is donated by, and it will be handed out by, Ilya Ovcharenko. And it goes to Kyoungsun Park. The third special prize is the Prix Fondation Thiébaut Frey, offered by the Thiébaut Frey Foundation and handed out by Madame Gabrielle Wanzenried, President of the Foundation. Welcome. Welcome, and I will step aside for you to give it to Roman Fediurko. The fourth special prize, Chopin Prize, offered by the Frédéric Chopin Society of Geneva, will be handed out by Ms. Aldona Jakobsen, President of the Chopin Society. Welcome. And that prize goes to Roman Fediurko. Thank you, thank you. The fifth special prize is the Vera Music Fund Prize, awarded to the best Ukrainian artist. Who knows, there were more. It will be handed out by founder of the Vera Music Fund, Tatiana Varevska. And it will go to Roman Fediurko, of course. The sixth and the last special prize is your prize. It is the audience award. You've all voted, and it worked because we got the votes and we counted them. And this prize is donated by the European Broadcasting Union, and it will be handed out by Pascal Labrie, head of music at EBU Media. And you may go to Roman Fediurko. Now the three main prizes. That includes cash, money, a medal, and engagements worldwide, including the Steinway & Sons Prize winners concerts, a South Korea concert tour thanks to SBU and partners, Vienna, concert organized by the Ferruccio Busoni International Piano Competition in Bolzano, the Clyburn International Piano Competition in Fort Worth, the Frédéric Chopin International Piano Competition in Warsaw, the International Franz Liszt Piano Competition, Liszt Utrecht, in Utrecht, and also a performance at Art Dialogue Festival 2023 in Biel. The third prize is the bronze medal. The certificate will be handed out by Kirill Karabits, and Peter Paul Kainrat will hand out the bronze medal. Do come forward, gentlemen. And you may hand it out to Kyoungsun Park. Congratulations, Kyoungsun. The second prize, it's the silver medal, It will be handed out again, the certificate by Kirill Karabits. The medal, the silver medal, will be handed out by Irina Postiankina. And you may give it to Julian Trevelyan. Julian, careful with your dog, that it doesn't bite the medal. And then the first prize, ladies and gentlemen, the gold medal, and therewith the winner of the Horowitz competition, KYIV-GENEVA 2023, will be announced. The certificate, again, will be handed over by Kirill Karabits. And Madame le Maire, Barbie Chapuis, mayor of Geneva, she will present the gold medal to, maybe we can say it together, Roman Fediurko. Roman, would you mind, I'm just very curious, how do you feel now with all these prizes?
Well, I probably feel a little bit sorry to stay on this stage for this such a lot of prizes. I am very honored for the appreciation of the audience, of the jury members. This week, my experience of participation in this competition has given me a huge and valuable experience and great joy. I value each moment of being in Geneva and performing for the wonderful audience. Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Congratulations again to you all. We will have pictures now. So we ask you to stay in the hall so we have space on the podium to take the pictures. After that, we'll have a cocktail party. You can congratulate our finalists and winners, hug them, kiss them. And you don't drink cocktails? Oh, there's the dog. Yes, we'll have some water for the dog, by the way. Yeah! Look at you! Well, one thing is for sure, it will be a wonderful party. Thank you to all the participants. Thank you, audience, for being with us here at Victoria Hall, Geneva. Via the live stream on YouTube, Medici.tv and Amadeus TV. My name is Christian Kuifhoven. It was a pleasure to be with you tonight. And give it one more hand for Kyoungsun Park, Julian Trevelyan, Roman Fediurko. Go into the lights. Guys, it's time for a drink. It's time for a drink. Let's go.